Aloha, this is Captain Terry Duffield, aka Coach Duff, with fishhound.com, the best place on the planet to get real-time fishing reports, salt and fresh water for the fly or conventional angler. Let's talk a little bit today about saltwater fly casting and some basic principles. Too often, clients come into my boat and they're ill-equipped and they're not ready to perform the basic cast needed out of a flats boat to pursue the biggest bonefish in the world that we have here in Hawaii. What I see is anglers who are semi-proficient in the 10 to 2 range, okay, the 10 to 2 range, but when the fly rod has to come out of that plane and go into other planes to make technical casts in all directions in a 360 degree direction out of the boat, they've never attempted those casts, they don't know how to make those casts, and they just flat suffer on a long day of bone fishing that they could have caught fish in, okay? In a flats boat or waiting in the flats environment, the fish are not always in front of you. The fish could be at 3 o'clock, the fish could be at 9 o'clock. You could have a fish behind your right shoulder. How do you get to that fish? It's not like this, okay? Remember, we push and we pull a fly rod. Okay, and with the proper application of power and a straight rod tip path, we're going to have a tight loop. With a straight rod tip path and a proper application of power, the hand can still be moved anywhere around the clock method and the cast still made, as long as the straight rod tip path and the proper application of power are constant, you're going to have a tight loop. So a 3 o'clock cast, which might come across your body and dumped over the right side, it's still going to give you a tight loop, and you can still throw 70, 80, 90 feet with a straight rod tip path, a proper application of power, and proper double hauling, which we talked about in an earlier segment when I showed you Mel Krieger's legendary down-up drill, the best way on the planet to build muscle memory and learn the double haul. If you couldn't see it, as if the video was a little bit small, I'm sure anywhere on YouTube you can find the down-up drill by Mel Krieger. Practice it in front of your TV. Getting back to getting out of the box then. So when you master the straight rod tip path and the proper application of power, the pushing and the pulling of the rod to bend it, not cast it. Remember, with a spinning rod, the weight of the lure carries the line, and with a fly rod, the weight of the line carries the lure, okay? There's a slight difference. We push and we pull the fly rod to a stop. Short cast, short stroke, short pause. Medium cast, medium stroke, medium pause. Long cast, long stroke, long pause. But I did not say in any of those three distances a harder cast. How you make up for the line speed to gain distance is reaching higher into the rod, following the line up on the previous haul, and ripping down with force. Get into that line and rip it with your fingertips ending up all the way behind your buttocks. That's the ripping motion you want to use on a 100-foot cast, 80-foot cast into the wind with a weighted fly, whatever you need to do. So, as I said earlier, in the saltwater fly game, let's get our minds out of the box. Let's remember a straight rod tip path and a proper application of power denote a tight loop. Double hauling is how we gain speed, and lengthening the fulcrum, or i.e. the stroke, is how we gain distance, but we don't have to pound the fly rod. This is your steering wheel, this is your accelerator. Steering wheel, accelerator, not accelerator, okay, and the double haul is a side note. Those two in conjunction, working together as a unit, boom, you can throw now a fly line in any direction possible, which is on the flats where the fish can come from, and hopefully you can throw to and hook this year the fish of a lifetime. This is Coach Duff for fishhound.com. Aloha and a hui ho.